Hello everyone, welcome to Excel 10 tutorial. In this advanced Excel tutorial, I will be talking about drop-down list or data validation list. Okay, in this tutorial, I'm going to cover how you can create a drop-down list from a comma separated list, how you can create a drop-down list from a range of cells, how you can copy your drop-down list to other cells, how you can handle error and error message, and also how you can add new data to your drop-down list. So let's get started. Take a look at here. I have question answer survey here and I want to create a drop down list here so that I can select yes or no answer. Okay, so this is a bit small list. I know the result is either yes or no, so I don't want to make it a range of list. I'm going to use comma separated list to create this drop down list. Okay, so simply select the cell and click on data and click on data validation. Now click here, select list. And now I'm going to write the comma separated list right here, and that will be our drop down list. Let's write it. So we write yes and no, and it's comma separated, and let's click OK. You can see our drop down list has created. Let's see. You can see it has two options, and I can simply use it as a drop down list. So this was our way to create a comma separated drop down list. Now we are going to create another drop down list that has a lots of options to select, and it's gonna be a long list. That's why we are going to create it from a range of cells, or we are going to create this from a source list. So our source list is here, and we're going to create a drop down list in this cell B7. So the question is, what is your profession? And we have a list of profession here. So click here again and click on data validation, click on list, and you can see source. Click here and simply go to that sheet and select the first one, and you can control shift down arrow. You can select all of them. Remember the keyboard command, control shift down arrow, and click again here and click OK. So we have created another drop down list from a source list, and here is our drop down. You can see I can select it from a list. Now I want to copy this drop down list in another position. Control C or copy this cell and paste another location. Control V, and you can see our drop down list is still working. Another way to copy drop down list is select the first one and then drag and click on data validation, and you'll get a message. The selection contains some cells without data validation settings. Do you want to extend data validation to this cell? If I click yes, and it will be asking for the source list, and if everything is all right, click OK. So our drop down list is created to all these cells. So this is how you can copy your drop down list to another location. Now what if I want to enter a profession that is not listed in our drop down list? Let's say doctor is not listed here, and if I press enter, you can see there is an error message, and it says this value doesn't match the data validation restriction defined for this cell. Either retry or cancel. So we can cancel it, and let me show you how you can control this error handling message. Okay, click on that cell, click on data validation, go to error alert, and there are three options here: stop, and then warning, and then information. You just saw what stop message can do, and if I select here warning, and let's give it an error message, add this to the list and click OK, and if we write doctor, you can see we are getting a message, and it's asking if you want to continue or not. If I say yes, our data has been input, but it's not in the list. Okay, and another option is information is basically the same thing, almost same. The difference is that you will not be giving a choice to continue yes or no. It's will just give you the information that this data needs to be added to the list. You can stop all the error messages if you select this one and uncheck this button, and from now on it won't ask for any error message. You can see there is no error message here. You can configure your error handling messages according to this. Now I'm going to show you how you can add data to your list. Okay, so if we add doctor here and press enter and go back to our sheet, and if we look at here, there is no changes because doctor hasn't been added here. So how you can add it? Simply select the data validation cell and click on data validation and go to settings, and you can add the cell range from here, or you can write it I prefer writing it. And there is this checkbox here. Apply these changes to all other cells with the same settings. That means if we don't check it, only the cell we are working on that will update the list. And if we click here and select this, all the data validation list that is using the current setting will be changed. And if we click OK, you can see here is our list. And let's see if it's updated here. Yes, it's updated here, and let's click on here, and it's updated here. And another thing, you can see this list is sorted, but you cannot sort the list from here. You will have to sort it from the base list. Select this list and you can click sort, and this is how you can sort the list, and the data validation list will be sorted accordingly. So this is what I wanted to show you, and this is the most important things you can learn about data validation or drop-down list in Microsoft Excel. Let me know if you have any question, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.